GFIs can be a bit of a nuisance. They do provide a level of protection from shock. These things will go bad by themselves. You're supposed to be able to push this button and get it to pop out here in a test, and you push the red button in to reset. This particular one has decided to fail. The GFI will protect just this outlet or outlets wired downstream of it. I like to put a label on here that tells me or reminds me what this GFI is protecting downstream. First thing you want to do is make sure that the power is turned off. Go to your circuit breaker and turn off the correct circuit, and then check it again with a volt ohmmeter. This one I've already loosened up. Carefully pull this out until you can access the wires on either side. This is slightly more difficult than replacing a single wall outlet or a wall switch, but not much. All we have to do is disconnect a few wires and reconnect them exactly like we find it on the new GFI. If you have a GFI that's feeding several receptacles downstream, there's going to be probably about 6 or 7 wires coming into this unit. If you think you're going to forget how this goes back together, take a picture. And the easiest way is don't disturb these wires too much as you pull this unit out of here. I've already loosened these. These two come out of here. This one's on the bottom. Same thing over there. So in this one we had 2 black wires on top, 2 white wires over here, a black and a white, and the ground is on the bottom. The GFI comes with the written instructions. Read all this, it's quite straightforward. And on the back of the unit, this is where the main power line from the circuit breaker comes in. White goes to silver, black goes to gold or brass. That unit's sitting in the wall like that. The sticker tells you these connections are feeding receptacles or lines that are downstream of the GFI. So the GFI is protecting itself and the lines that are connected here. Your wire goes into this hole, then you tighten the screw to tighten the wire. Same thing here, except the wire comes in here a little bit further. Goes in here. When you tighten this up, it tightens up on the 2 wires. Take a new unit, connect the ground wire, turn it back to the orientation that the one was before, the red on top, black on the bottom. We know that black goes to gold, white goes to silver. Just reinstall the wires like you found on the original unit. The line in wires will plug into a hole down here on the bottom, and the wires leading to the outlets downstream will be attached to these upper screws, and there's usually a tape across here that says that these connections are feeding additional receptacles. And this is fairly easy if there's not a camera in the way. A lot of these are just wired to protect a single outlet, so there's just going to be 2 wires in the ground. And these do need to be tight. Got that done. Now we just have to get the black ones in here. These are fairly expensive. They're about $15 a piece. I have no idea what an electrician would charge you to come install these for you. It's not that hard to do. You do need to pay attention to what you're doing. cover plate back on. Turn the power back on. Plug in the light. The light's working. You can push this down here to test. The power went off. You can push the red one to reset. The light came back on. And you can go downstream and verify that the other outlets are working. Before we throw it away, let's look inside here. Do a little dissection on this thing. When you push the black test button, you're actually making contact across the terminals. You're shorting it out. That will trip the unit. Then when you push this, it resets it. Pull out some of these pieces. You take one of these apart, you're probably not going to get it back together again. We'll just bend that up out of the way. A little more coaxing. Pop that off of there. We had a thunderstorm the other day and the power went on and off several times. That probably killed this. You have a circuit board, a coil, a little solenoid, and a spring. And if you have a scrap brass bucket, you can throw those pieces in there. The rest of it, throw it away.